In Oklahoma, that ties the Prague earthquake back in 2011, and it was out there towards Pawnee, about 8.5 miles northwest of Pawnee.
I'm really pretty angry about the earthquake.
That's what really upsets me. I said, here, we got to pay for it.
It's not going to stop. Everything's been set into motion already. I mean, one earthquake always leads to another.
Welcome to the small rural community of Pawnee, Oklahoma, where neighbors know each other by first name and where a streetlight separates roaming buffalo from city limits.
Pawnee's a wonderful town.
A community where you can expect a seasonal tornado. It's also a place where the last thing you'd expect is an earthquake.
Every single day there's been an earthquake.
Pawnee made national headlines back in September 2016 when it was struck by a 5.8 magnitude earthquake, Oklahoma's largest on record. Worst of all, the rumblings aren't natural.
This is not a natural disaster. This is a man-made disaster. This could have been avoided.
The problem started probably in 2008 when the oil and gas activity really picked up here in Oklahoma, and especially with regards to the new techniques that they were using in oil and gas extraction.
Since local oil operators began employing fracking and horizontal drilling methods, the number of earthquakes of a 3.0 magnitude or above went from just 3 in 2009 to 623 in 2016. These processes also extract more of the toxic, super salty water along with it. This is where the water is injected 1 to 3 miles underground. The toxic salt water then aggravates existing fault lines, ultimately causing the ground to shake.
When your home is attacked, you're going to fight for it, and that's what the Pawnee Nation is doing.
Andrew Knife Chief is the executive director of the Pawnee Nation. The tribe has called the area its home since the 1870s. The tribe's reservation has been in the middle of the massive quakes, and the wear and tear is taking its toll.
If we lose our buildings and we lose our water, where do we go? I mean, this is all we have as a nation is right here.
I feel defeated.
I want to be living in a safe house.
Across town, Janice and Johnny Bryant have been living in Pawnee their whole lives.
We just met at school.
Geometry class.
Well, probably flunked you.
Their home suffered over $200,000 of damages as a result of the massive September 3rd quake.
I think the only thing we can probably do is probably tear this thing down and start over again.
We've still got to get a structural engineer.
Not too far from the Bryants live the Haslips.
See how it's cracked?
Along with countless number of cracks in their foundation caused by the 2016 earthquake. Their barn also burned to the ground during that long summer day.
It upsets me that these earthquakes continue to rumble because we know what the problem is and it's not being taken care of.
The Oklahoma Corporation Commission, the agency that oversees the local oil and gas industry, has taken steps to try and slow down the quakes. More than 700 disposal wells have cut their volume by at least 40%. And in the most earthquake-prone areas like Pawnee, about 85 wells are on indefinite shutdown. And while the earthquakes have managed to taper off, the people of Pawnee are still at risk. Scientists we spoke with stated that even though some wells are turned off, the damage is done. Earthquakes may continue for years to come.